personal finance. So how does he think American workers will do under a Trump presidency? Dave Ramsey joins me now. We will just ask him. Before we ask you that direct question, though, you taped a message to your fans. It was back in January when the primary elections were heating up. Let's listen to it.
There's nobody on the news channel that's going to fix your life. There's no government program that's going to fix your life. There's no Republican that if he gets elected is going to become Jesus. And there's no Democrat that if they get elected is going to be the Jesus of your life and give you everything you ever wanted. It's an absolute lie. And it's been going on since man invented politics, I guess. Do not let a politician, do not let a news anchor become the hero in your story. You are the hero in your story.
So why do you think, Dave, that Americans pin our hopes on politicians? Do you think that we expect politicians to fix our money problems?
Well, we all love a good story. We still want the Lone Ranger to ride in on a white horse and save the day and fix us. And some of the Trump voters wanted to do that. Some of the Hillary voters wanted to do that. We've always wanted a Ronald Reagan to come in and fix our life. Some people wanted Bill Clinton to come in and fix their life. And it's a misnomer because it steals the dignity of the individual. Because as individuals in a free market culture, we've got the ability to get up, leave the cave, kill something, and drag it home. And if our career track's not working out, we've got the ability to retool and reset our lives. But when we sit back and wait on someone in a network, you or me sitting and looking at these cameras, or we look at someone in Washington to fix our lives, we always end up with a life that sucks because no one is coming to fix your life.
Yeah. Okay, so speaking of retooling, when you look at, you know, what's happening in the Rust Belt, when you look at, you know, maybe in coal country, you know, the candidates were, especially Donald Trump, saying, you know,
without a doubt, it'll affect the production of oil and other things like that, energy-based things, because of the energy policies coming out of Washington. But at the end of the day, if you're looking at a job that someone's been doing for 100 years, honestly, the likelihood is, unless you're doing it in a boutique setting, you're probably not going to be doing that in 30 or 40 years. We are seeing a shift with the power of the internet. We're seeing a shift with the power of technology, and the way I do my job, the way you do your job in broadcasting is substantially shifted, and our access to markets are different. And if you don't adapt and change with that...
Once made videotape, which really doesn't exist, and it's all digital now. So, well, you know,
exactly.
My question was, how will we fare under Donald Trump presidency of the economy? So you can answer it, I think, in this question. He calls on the chairman of United Technology, and then the next thing we know, say that for these families, that Donald Trump is actually a hero in their stories?
Yeah, for 800 people. There's 300 million of us out here, though. And, you know, logistically, your last guest was absolutely correct. The ability of him to go around on a micro, one-off basis and do these deals all over the place and single-handedly save the economy is just, that's ludicrous. What he can do, and what a president can do, realistically, is set an environment, a predictable environment, where business that is doing value-enhancing things to a community, that capitalism that's sanctified, capitalism that's moral, can grow. If we, those of us that run business, I've got 600 team members on my team. I hired 135 people last year. I need a predictable environment where government is not a tick on my backside sucking the blood out of my cash flow, and then I'll create jobs for you because I want to grow my business. It's the very nature, and I want to help my customers, and the more customers I help, the more people I need to hire. And the same's true at CNN, the same's true at any other business that's out there where we're bringing value to the economy and value to the community. And he just needs to create the environment where we can do that again and then step back and let that happen. The problem I've got is when these politicians come in and say, I created jobs. Mm-hmm. There's no politician creates jobs. Business creates jobs.
Yeah. It reminded me of what you just said, reminded me of what I don't know if you heard, I quoted Sarah Palin when she said she was concerned about the heavy hand of government that Republicans oppose this. Remember, instead we support competition on a level playing field. Remember, because we know special interest crony capitalism is one big fail. And you seem to be echoing what she's her sentiments. Is that correct?
Maybe a little. I don't know if I want to be accused of agreeing with Sarah on something, but you know, the bottom line is this. I mean, that's kind of a Tea Party line, if you want to take that. And if you want to be a libertarian in the economy and say, let the free market do its thing, yeah, I'll line up and I'll march to that. Because again, I know where jobs come from. I'm literally creating them. I own a business that hires people. And people that, you know, small businesses, there's 27 million small businesses in America. They need a predictable environment in the economy, and they will create jobs. You don't have to go give them stuff like they did at Carrier. Mm-hmm. We'll just do it. Just don't take stuff from us. Mm-hmm. That's all we're asking.
Dave Ramsey, I want you to stick around. When we come right back, I want to know what advice would you give to President-elect Donald Trump? We'll be right back.